Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Ha. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Away from what promises to be an epic night of martial arts action tomorrow night from inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium, 1:58, Tawanchai versus Larsen. Hello everybody, Michael Chiavello, great to be here, circle side in Singapore, super excited for tomorrow night. We've got grudge matches, we've got scores to settle, we've got fights with world title implications, Muay Thai, kickboxing, mixed martial arts, and a swag of heavyweight concept. It's all going down here tomorrow night. And to meet our athletes for the first time and put them head to head, face to face, and on the scales, let's go to Dom Lau.
Kicking things off in a one lightweight mixed martial arts contest. Up first from Brazil, Edson Panico Marquez.
The very slick Edson Marquez says a new camp, new training partners means we'll see Marquez version 2.0 tomorrow night.
170 pounds for Edson Marquez.
170 pounds, spot on the money for Edson Marquez of Brazil, kicking off our lead card tomorrow night.
And his opponent from South Korea, Kim Kyung Lok.
The very quiet spoken but heavy hitting South Korean Kim Kyung Lok onto the scales now. He'll take on Edson Marquez, first fight on tomorrow night's lead card.
170 pounds for Kim Kyung Lok.
Kim Kyung Lok looking good, also weighs in at 170. Here they are head to head for the very first time. Is it a screen mask on Edson Marquez? It is. So Marquez not taking his eyes off Kim Kyung Lok. And Kim Kyung Lok responding, puts the right fist in the face of the Brazilian. That will kick off our lead card with fireworks tomorrow night here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium.
And now, in a one atom weight mixed martial arts contest, Brazil's Julie Mezabarba!
The return of Brazil's Julie Mezabarba as she takes on Jenil and Olsen. Both ladies were semi-finalists in the one atom weight World Grand Prix.
115 pounds for Julie Mezabarba!
Fantastic striker, Mezabarba, and as always, looking in tip-top condition.
And her opponent from the Philippines, Shinalyn, the graceful Olsen.
Out of the fabled team Lakai in Baguio City in the Philippines, Shinalyn Olsen, also a semi-finalist in the one atomweight World Grand Prix.
115 pounds for Jenilyn Olsen.
Olsen, who comes in having competed in the Southeast Asian Games and medaling in the Vietnamese martial art of Vovinam just recently. And look at the difference here. Mezabarba staring her down. Olsen assumes the fight position. Great stare down between these two semi-finalists from that one atomweight World Grand Prix.
Coming up now in a one heavyweight Mixed Martial Arts Contest. Uzbekistan's Jasur Mirzamugamedov.
One of the swag of heavyweight contest tomorrow night. This gentle giant outside the circle, ready to do damage inside the circle. Jasur Mirzamugamedov.
261 pounds for Jasur Mirzamugamedov.
Just about at that 265 limit, 261 even for Jasur Mirzamugamedov.
And his opponent from Australia, Duke, the Duke of Canberra, Didier!
BJJ and judo stylist, a champion in both martial arts, also competed in the Commonwealth Games, was an Olympic Games alternate in judo. It's Duke Didier, who these days resides in Melbourne, Australia. The Aussie flag about to be draped over the shoulders of Duke Didier.
233 pounds for Duke Didier!
233 gives up quite a bit of weight there to Mirzamugamedov, but Didier says he can take down anyone in one championship. Can he take down Jasur Mirzamugamedov, who has a huge size differential on the Aussie? Just stop. Look at that size of the chest there on Jasur. And Duke Didier says he's going to take him down, finish him off inside of the opening 5 minutes. Jasur says he knocks him out standing on the feet, Muay Thai style. Banger of a heavyweight contest.
Coming up on stage now in a one heavyweight mixed martial arts contest, representing Iran, Mehdi Barghi.
The Iranian battering ram, Mehdi Barghi, returns to action as he takes on Odi Delaney. Iran versus the USA in a heavyweight stout. Both men have promised fast finishes.
254 pounds for Mehdi Barghi.
Gotta say, Mehdi Barghi, with a new management, looking in tremendous shape.
And his opponent from the United States of America, Odi, the Witness Delaney!
He is a massive unit and he is undefeated. Odi Delaney from the USA. United States Wrestling versus Iranian Wrestling.
260 pounds for Odi Delaney!
260 pounds, Odi Delaney. Mehdi Barghi, 254 pounds. Battle of the behemoths. But look how Odi Delaney towers over Mehdi Barghi once again. The USA versus Iran. Is there a gift here from Mehdi Barghi to Odi Delaney? You know, here's a little... No, he's giving him either a chocolate bar or a protein bar. One or the other. Looks like a chocolate bar. Don't quite know the significance of that, but I'm sure Odi Delaney doesn't need any more chocolate.
And now, in a one heavyweight mixed martial arts contest, Australia's Simon Carson!
You know, the call went out around the world, through Europe, the USA, South America, all around Asia, for somebody to fight Marcus, Buchecha, Almeida. Everyone said no, except for this Aussie, Simon Carson.
233 pounds for Simon Carson!
Carson says he can knock out Marcus Buchecha Almeida tomorrow night.
And his opponent from Brazil, Marcus Buchecha Almeida!
Many people touting this man as a future heavyweight champion. Buchecha, 15-time BJJ world champ, undefeated in mixed martial arts.
255 pounds for Marcus Almeida!
Buchecha comes in an overwhelming favourite for this one, but recently here at One Championship, we've seen the underdogs come through and Simon Carson use those massive meat hooks of his to knock out Buchecha tomorrow, or will Buchecha take him down and sub out the Australian?
Up next in a one lightweight kickboxing contest, Moldova's Constantin Lion Crusher Rusu.
If you've never seen Konstantin Rusu fight before, you're in for a treat tomorrow. He's a very slick kickboxer, a lot of volume.
169 pounds for Konstantin Rusu.
Plays him nicely, does the Moldovan, Konstantin Rusu against Marouane Tutu.
And his opponent, representing the Netherlands and Morocco, Marouane Tutu.
Marouane Tutu, and in his corner, in the cap there, a living legend, one of the greats, Ivan Hippolyte.
170 pounds for Marouane Tutu.
Very good boxer, good counter boxing, great leg kicks, long reach on Tutu. This one should be a ripper, a kickboxing contest on our lead card. And they are not breaking stare. Konstantin Rusu and Marouane Tutu. Who's going to break first, do you reckon? I think Tutu. No, neither man. Tutu wins that contest. That's going to be a good one.
Coming up on stage now in a one flyweight mixed martial arts contest representing India and Canada, Gurdarshan St. Lion Mega.
This is our final fight of our lead card tomorrow night, the return of Gurdarshan Mangat.
135 pounds for Gurdarshan Mega.
Gurdarshan looking ripped, stripped and striated. The man they call St. Lion returning to action.
And his opponent, Thailand's Yut Kai Khao, Y2K Fairtax.
He entered one on an absolute blitz. Ran into some hurdles in his last couple. Can Yut Kai Khao Fairtax Y2K get back in the winner's circle with those tubbing, thumping leg kicks?
135 pounds for Yut Kai Khao Fairtax.
Y2K and Gurdarshan Mangat both making weight, both passing hydration. That is the final fight on our lead card tomorrow night here inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Great stare down here between Gurdarshan and Yut Kai Khao. Thailand versus India. It's going to be nasty.
Kicking off our main card tomorrow night in a one strawweight mixed martial arts contest from Indonesia, Adrian Papua Padboy Mattheis.
I said earlier that sometimes the underdogs do it. Well, if one lights out, this man, Adrian Mattheis, shocked the world when he beat Alex Silva. It was controversial. Now we get the rematch.
125 pounds for Adrian Mattheis.
The Papua bad boy who missed hydration just slightly has until midday tomorrow to pass hydration. Shouldn't be a problem.
And his opponent, Brazil's Alex Little Rock Silva.
The former strawweight champion of the world was none too pleased in what he called an early stoppage when they first fought. He says he will turn the tables tomorrow night.
125 pounds for Alex Silva.
A score to settle for Little Rock Alex Silva. Now, I quote, Alex told us a couple of days ago, I am going to finish Mattheis with a submission the likes of which has never been seen before in one championship. We can't wait to see what the former world champion left of screen has in his bag of BJJ tricks for the Papua bad boy, Adrian Mattheis, in this much-anticipated rematch.
Facing off next in a one heavyweight kickboxing contest from Brazil, Guto, Inocente.
Highly experienced striker, Guto Inocente returns to action. He'll take on Rade, Opacic. Guto looking in fabulous shape as always. Onto the scale goes the big fella.
264 pounds for Guto Inocente.
So looking over my notes, I believe that Guto wins the award for the heaviest competitor tomorrow night at 263.
And his opponent, Serbia's Rade Opacic.
Now, Rade Opacic, who has been undefeated in one super series, going 4-0, beating every one of those opponents in the second round. He'll probably give up, I'd say, around 15 pounds to the massive Guto Inocente here. Opacic does have the height, though.
247 pounds for Rade Opacic.
I don't know, folks. For me, this is a show stealer tomorrow night. The Dragon Mitch Chilson believes it will go the distance. I believe Rade can knock him out and keep that fabulous streak alive and the stare down here. As I said, weight goes the way of Guto Inocente. Also, a tremendous experience advantage to the Brazilian. Rade Opacic, though, has momentum on his side, has height, has reach, and has a great stare down as well. They are not breaking gaze, these two heavyweight kickboxers. A little bit of smack talk, bit of nodding. They are ready to go tomorrow night.
Up next in a one flyweight mixed martial arts contest, Japan's Tatsumitsu, the sweeper, Wada.
He gave Demetrius Johnson one of DJ's toughest tests of his career. He still gives Reece McLaren nightmares. It's Tatsumitsu Wada of Japan.
135 pounds for Tatsumitsu Wada.
On the money, 135 even for Tatsumitsu Wada as he gets a set to take on a former world champion.
And his opponent from Kazakhstan, Kairat, the Kazakh, Akhmetov.
Kazakh wrestling champion, former world champion, Kairat Akhmetov. Will he take Wada down and out-wrestle him all night? We'll see.
135 pounds for Kairat Akhmetov.
Akhmetov says, I will handle Wada tomorrow night. After him, I want Demetrius Johnson. Once I wipe the floor with DJ, his words, not mine, I want Adrian Amorais for the belt. That's the path that Kairat Akhmetov has laid to get the title back. Wada says, I'll have none of that. I'm going to finish the former world champion. Good sportsmanship there between Wada and Kairat Akhmetov.
Up next in a one flyweight mixed martial arts contest, China's the Hunter, Xie Wei.
Gotta love this guy, Xie Wei of China, the Hunter. And he has set his sights on Reece McLaren of Australia. The Chinese flag comes out to go over the shoulder of Xie Wei. And he hops onto the scales.
134 pounds for Xie Wei.
Passes weight, passes hydration, easy. A lot of support for the Hunter, Xie Wei of China.
And his opponent, representing Australia, Reece Lightning McLaren.
Reece McLaren with the great John Wayne Parr in his corner. They've been together since January, and Reece says we're going to see a McLaren version 2.0 who will be striking heavy tomorrow.
134 pounds for Reece McLaren.
Lightning looking sharp, as I said, with 10-time world champion Wayne Parr in his corner. Plans to sit down on those punches, go heavy to the jaw, heavy to the body of Xie Wei, and Xie Wei getting in Reece's face here. The first time they have met face-to-face, Lightning Reece McLaren and the Hunter from China, Xie Wei. This one should be an absolute corker.
Coming on stage now in a one bantamweight mixed martial arts contest, Brazil's Fabricio Wonderboy Andrade.
This guy is a freak, undefeated in his entire career. What is it, 6-0, 7-0, Fabricio Andrade. He is a sniper. He's got the Muay Thai, he's got the ground game, he's got everything. And he's already called out John Lineker.
145 pounds for Fabricio Andrade.
Andrade says, I'll beat Kwon Won Il, then you can give me Viviano Fernandez, I'll take care of him, then I want Lineker.
And his opponent from South Korea, pretty boy, Kwon Won Il.
Kwon Won Il has been lighting people up in one championship, the number two in the division.
144 pounds for Kwon Won Il.
This could be fight of the night right here. Number two takes on number four. There's been trash talk between them. Oh, look at this. Andrade in the face of Kwon Won Il.
Oh,
Oh, headbutts going on, and Rick Hawtey forced a stand between them, and that could have gotten nasty. Kwon Won Il said, and I quote, "I would have punched Andrade in the mouth because it's a big mouth. Someone needs to close it. I'm going to close it." You can see it right there. They do not like each other. Let's go to Tom Lau now. This one is heated.
All right, before we meet our next two warriors, here is a preview of what you can expect tomorrow night at 1:58.
We are all different. We all have goals and dreams.
ความฝันใหม่ของผมครับในรายการวันครับก็อยากได้แชมเปี้ยนวันครับ
I'm here to make my come true. My first pro debut ended up being a world title. And I surprised everyone. I took the belt. I showed that I belong with the best. I got a staph infection. Came to the hospital and I was in this hill where I was screaming and they just told me, we don't know if we have to cut your leg. 3 months I couldn't walk. Through hard work and dedication, I was able to come back to what I love.
ความฝันมีกันทุกคนครับก็อยู่ที่ว่าใครจะทำความหมายของใครให้สำเร็จก่อนครับ
Tawanchai, the epitome of Muay Thai perfections.
เวลาขึ้นสังเวียนก็อยากให้ผู้ชกเตรียมตัวมาดีครับมีนับน็อกก็ได้ครับ
Oh my word, that was a javelin, a harpoon.
Just precision.
ให้จดจำตะวันฉายไว้ให้เป็นตำนานคนหนึ่งเลยแบบว่านักมวยไทยคนนี้คือเคยเป็นนักมวยคนมีคนติดตามชื่นชอบเยอะอะไรเงี้ยครับ
We have just seen someone very, very special.
ฝันเหมือนกันก็มาสู้กันครับไฟนี้ถ้าต่อยลาเซ่นครับก็คิดว่าน่าจะผ่าน 100% ครับ
I don't feel bad being the underdog. I have the tools, I can stop the fight.
จะเอาให้น็อกเอาให้ได้ครับ
I would love to shock the world.
Tawanchai, Niclas Larsen. Who's next in line for the world title?
And now we have come to the main event in a one featherweight Muay Thai contest. Denmark's Niclas "Dreamchaser" Larsen.
It's an amazing story for Niclas Larsen, and he is quite an amazing Muay Thai athlete.
154 pounds for Niclas Larsen.
You know, Niclas Larsen has fought so many ties. He's beaten so many ties. He's picked that lock on a number of occasions, and he picked the lock of Tawanchai.
And his opponent, representing Thailand, Tawanchai PK.Saenchai.
So fast, so strong, so precise. He is a once-in-a-generation athlete. He is special, Tawanchai.
155 pounds for Tawanchai PK.Saenchai.
This is going to be a Muay Thai showdown for the ages. It's a world title eliminator. The winner will get the champion Pet Morricot next. Can Niclas Larsen pick that lock? Tawanchai, will he level up even more? He is exceptional. This has the makings of an absolute Muay Thai classic in our main event tomorrow night.At 1:58, Tawanchai versus Larsen. Let's go to Mitch Chilson now to chat to both these main eventers.
I am here with one half of your main event, Niclas Larsen. I know you've got some big stage experience, some high-level ties that you've fought in the past, but how excited are you for this opportunity tomorrow night?
Wow, I'm so excited. This is just amazing. I don't know what's happening. I'm living the dream. That's it.
I know you are possibly one of the nicest guys in kickboxing, but how does this match go down tomorrow?
Well, what I really want to say to Tawanchai is that I hope that you will bring your absolute best. I know we can make something really beautiful, so let's make it a war. bring your best, your A game. Please let me give you all you have. Please.
Oh, that's good. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Niclas Larsen, the Dream Chaser. I am here with the other half of the main event, Tawanchai PK.Saenchai. Now, sir, you are ready. The possible title shot hangs in the balance against Pet Morakot. How are you feeling going into tomorrow night's main event?
ตอนนี้รู้สึกเป็นยังไงมั้งครับเพราะว่าตอนนี้เนี่ยเรามีเข็มขัดเป็นเดิมพันนะครับ
ครับก็ I ready I want to the win I can't to lose next fight I want a world champion
All right now tomorrow night you've made a bold prediction in how this match ends how does it go down tomorrow night
คุณรู้สึกยังไงมั้งครับที่คุณแบบว่าคิดไว้ว่าพรุ่งนี้จะต้องชนะน็อกเอาท์แน่ๆตอนนี้ยังรู้สึกยังไงหรือเปล่าครับ
ก็ตอนนี้ก็รู้สึกก็เต็มที่ครับรอดูกันพรุ่งนี้ดีกว่าครับไม่อยากพูดอะไรเยอะครับ
I am 100% sure I don't want to talk too much let's wait and see tomorrow
Man a few words let's wait and see Ladies and gentlemen that's your main event it goes down live tomorrow night from the Singapore Indoor Stadium at 1:158 and we will see you tomorrow night.